Ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome to Jack Della Maddalena up against Randy Brown at UFC 284 in Perth. How cool is it to be the hometown kid fighting on the UFC massive card, and you're an absolute knockout artist? Seems like life's going well for you.
Yeah, it is so exciting. You know, I've drove past that arena many times, and I've actually always thought I would definitely fight there one day. So it's come at the perfect time. I'm so excited.
Is it a special time as well? Maybe if you want to say not just for Aussie MMA, but maybe Anzac MMA, like it feels like a bit of a golden era.
Yeah, for sure. It's one of those classic cards where there's a lot of Aussie and New Zealand people on the card. They have been to Perth once before, and it was a pretty insane card. I know the crowd went off. There was a lot of, as you said, Anzacs fighting, and I think everyone did well. So, yeah, I'm excited. I feel like I'm battling for my, like, state and territory in Australia.
Can you tell me a bit about where you train and who you train with? Because you've been on my radar for a couple of years, and just as someone super exciting, I've been keen to speak to you, but I'd love to know a bit more about your background.
Train at Scrappy MMA, just around the corner, like 15 minutes out of the city. And yeah, I've been training there since I was probably about 16 years old. Pretty much just from that get-go, trained a lot with my brother from a young age, maybe even before that, just trained boxing and fighting with my brother. We were always into it, and he's a big part of my career and why I'm here.
How much is rugby a solid base for MMA fighters? Obviously, we've got Volk in the main event. We've had Tai Tuivasa. I know they're a rugby league, you were union, right? But like, seems like solid. Like, there's been a few down the years who've done really, really well in the UFC, started out playing rugby.
Yeah, I think, I played a lot of rugby. Before I was interested in fighting, rugby was a big part of my life. I played since a young age. I think rugby, it's a pretty physical game, you know. I think everyone that does rugby, most of them have a strong teamwork, you know, so they can fit into a gym, and I think they're used to that, like, physical contact. So I think it translates. I found that, like, wrestling, I came sort of natural. No, obviously there's a lot more to it than that, but just trying to get in there and tackle someone, like, I've been doing that since I was a young age. So I think, as you said, it shows in all those guys.
And you've been sparking people out. I saw the Chuck Liddell record. Who was the guy for you growing up in the UFC? Was it Chuck Liddell, or, you know, the guy you just was the man?
I like Chuck Liddell for sure. I think the first person I was really into, I thought Wanderlei Silva was the man. Remember when I was really young, I watched like some of his highlight videos, sort of thing from. And I like that, his style, just like a brute, like come after you and have a fight.
For this generation, how much of an inspiration is Volk for Australians and also for helping to raise the game? He's kind of done it his way. Like, he wasn't really a star for a long time, but then just keep letting his performances do the talking. I mean, what's the buzz like in terms of Australia and what he's been able to do right now?
Yeah, he's obviously just paved the way. He's like, people like Robert Whittaker are in there, and they prove that Australian MMA can get to the top. And I think it just comes from fighting hard and fighting consistently and keep trying to get better. And Volk, obviously he's definitely pound for pound number one at the moment. And I think he's got a tough fight in front of him. I definitely think he can win that and get to the top of the sport.
You've got a tough one in Randy Brown. Does that please you? Do you want the toughest dudes? I mean, I speak to some fighters, they're like, no, I want the easiest dudes and I want to get paid. But how do you feel about Randy Brown? And are you more motivated just to take the roof off and just get another knockout?
Yeah, I can see how some people want to take the easiest fights for most money. It makes sense. But I don't know. I just want to fight probably always try and fight the toughest person I can. I think that's just how you get the best out of yourself, you know, is fighting better people. I think that's when you really get a bit nervous and then you fight better, I believe. So I think that's it. I think Randy's a good competitor and I can't wait.
He's doing pretty well himself on a bit of a tear. Have you been impressed with him for 4 straight wins?
Yeah, for sure. I remember I hadn't really heard of him and I watched him fight Trinaldo a few months ago. And when I saw that, I thought, it would be cool to fight that guy. I think he's good. He's got a good style. And I thought at the time, I reckon put me in there, I can beat him. So. Yeah, I think I can beat him.
How far away are you from a Leon Edwards right now, do you reckon?
I don't know. I think they're probably, hopefully this far I can get into that top 15, you know. I think there's guys that Leon obviously needs to fight now because there's a lot of guys in front of me. But yeah, I just want to hopefully after this fight crack the top 15 and then just keep taking the toughest fight that I can at the toughest opponent that's offered to me and have a good solid scrap with them.
Are you pleased that Leon kind of shook up the division a bit? It felt like Kamaru was just going to hold the belt indefinitely and he just seemed unstoppable with his wrestling, but has it freshened things up and added something having a new champ?
I think so. I think Usman was not, yeah, I don't know. I think he was very lucky with some of his fights. I think he's obviously very good. He's got a nice wrestling style, but I like to see someone with a bit of striking prowess as number one, you know, so it's cool to see Leon up there.
How do you feel about the Masvidal Burns matchup?
I think that's a great matchup. I think, yeah, I reckon Gilbert Burns looked good after his last fight. Masvidal is obviously a legend. Love to fight the loser, maybe. I obviously can't fight the winner. I'll fight the loser of that fight, if that was possible.
Equality. And your record's crazy because, like, you had those couple of losses in Eternal and you got one of them back big time. What was going through your head when you had those first two losses? Were you having doubts, is this the sport for me? And then you kind of never looked back.
Yeah, of course. Definitely there were doubts. It was like, oh, that sucks. Like, especially having a third fight, just that pressure of losing the third fight, but it was hard. But I still loved the sport and I still thought I could get better, you know. Still had like, and I pretty much just stayed consistent with, because I loved training. I loved getting better. And then, of course, I loved to compete. So I just stayed positive and set a big goal and just hammered away at it.
What a massive future that you're only 26 and in this kind of form, you were voted Rookie of the Year. What did that mean to you?
It was pretty cool, you know. It was such a cool year for me. I had a fight in January, so it's kicked the year. It started with a fight, which was perfect, and then wanted to get four in, but I had like my son Franco was born, so I chucked a little bit of time where I had to take, like, not fight for a brief period of time. Got three fights and it was an awesome year. It was a good way to finish it off. But yeah, I'm glad that's in the past. You know, I want to fight the top people now.
Congrats on the birth of your son, mate. We're going to finish off with a little quickfire about your UFC colleagues, if that's all right. So now that Francis is gone, who's the hardest hitter in the UFC?
The hardest hitter? It's a good question. I think, are we talking pound for pound or are we talking just the hardest?
It's got to be, I think we've got to be pound for pound to make it fair, right?
You're looking at him.
Quality. Right. You've got to back yourself.
No, I think actually, maybe that Sergey Pav. I think you've got to look at the big Russian Pavlovich.
Yeah,
you know, I think bang. If you're looking at just the hardest hitter, I think he's the hardest.
Who's the best wrestler?
Best wrestler? Who is? That's a hard one. I don't know. You have to say Makachev.
Yeah.
That's what I would believe.
Fair play.
And but I think Gold might be able to do pretty well with him, but yeah, probably Makachev.
Who's the funniest?
Oh, I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know. Sean Strickland seems pretty funny in a funny way.
Who's the most annoying?
Also Sean Strickland, probably.
And who's the best looking?
I reckon myself.
Fair play. And who would you most like to have dinner with?
Oh, Randy Brown. Love to have dinner with him when he's in town.
After knocking him out, I assume.
Yeah. Or before, I don't mind.
And who's got the best fight IQ?
Who's really good? I think Volkanovski. Alexander Volkanovski.
Who's the most interesting female fighter?
Interesting. Casey O'Neill. She's the best.
She's awesome. And who's got the coolest tattoos?
I'm not sure. I have no idea. Who's got funny tattoos? No idea. I'm not sure. Tony Ferguson. He's the first one that comes to mind, I guess.
Who would you most want by your side in a street fight?
Probably Sergey Pavlovich. We probably
smash. And then who's the most stylish, the best dressed?
Best dressed. I think Israel Adesanya is pretty well dressed. It's a stylish man.
And the last one then, who would be your dream fight, past or present, and in any weight class?
Oh, dream fight, anyone. Maybe Wanderlei Silva in like a pride ring. That's pretty cool.
Love it. Mate, it's been a pleasure. How do I reach out to you for future interviews? I sometimes reach out for interviews on IG, but for obvious reasons, not everyone checks those. Is there an email address or anything I could reach out in the future?
I don't have a direct one.
Or a manager?
Just go direct. He said, go directly to the UFC. Is that how this one came through?
Yes. Yeah.
Perfect.
Cool. All right, mate. Good luck. Thank you very much. Thank you.